Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
And good afternoon. Welcome to the comedy room here at the Flatwoods Public Library. It's actually the Kentucky Room. I'm Hank Bond, along with these three lovely ladies. And your name is?
Melissa Latimer.
Your name is?
Peggy Carter.
Terry Caseman.
And from this point on, I don't have to remember it. And, you know, that really makes no difference whatsoever. But anyway, today in Education in Action, we'll be talking about the preschool program down at Greenup County Schools, a great program for young people which prepares folks for mainstreaming when they get into the first grade and lose all the creativity. You know how it works. So anyway, we'll be back with our wonderful lineup of guests here today in a minute. I'm surprised Sherry didn't send a whole bus full down here, but they wouldn't have fit in the picture. We'll be back in a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body, and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
At Carmen Funeral Home, for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services complemented by the finest products. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
I'm a single mother, and I was the main one working, so I never thought that I could go back to school, you know. My sister, my mother, everybody wanted to help me with my kids. I could not have gotten my diploma without my family.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
At First and People's Bank and Trust, we're not only your home office, we're your hometown bank. We're your friends, your neighbors, even your relatives. When you enter our front door, you're going to be our number one priority, because here at First and People's Bank, we're here to serve you. Tired of dealing with that corporate bank where you're just a number? Come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust, where we'll treat you just like a friend. Whether you're buying your first house, your second house, or financing a new car, come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust.
Hank Bond here on Education in Action, our new program this year. Our second month go around, the first Wednesday of last month, which I don't remember what month that was, but I think it was September. Sherry Horsley was on, superintendent of Greenup County, and I texted her day before yesterday, and I said, don't forget you're on Wednesday. And she said, what time and where is it? And I said, I'm in trouble. And then all of a sudden I get a text about 11 o'clock that says, Miss Latimer will be there. And I said, okay, and who's that? And so from there, we have the preschool program from the Greenup County School District. And Miss Latimer, you're large and in charge now. So tell me about your education background and what you do at the district.
Okay. I have a degree, a K-12 learning and behavior disorder degree from Morehead State University, and then a K-4, 5th and 6th self-contained elementary degree from Morehead State. That's my bachelor's. My master's is in special education and assistive technology from the University of Louisville, and then I have a rank 1 as director from Morehead State University as well.
Yeah, we Cardinals are not doing so well today.
I know.
Like him or not, I hate to see what it does to the kids and to the school.
Yes.
So.
Because the school is wonderful.
And you're from where? Where did you go to? Listen to this, where she went to school. This was great.
Yes. I actually grew up on the backside of Flatwoods. And at the time.
How would we have ever known?
Yes. At the time, you could walk one direction and go to Greenup and the other direction and go to Russell. So I actually attended Downton Elementary, which was in Greenup. Russell Middle, and then Greenup County High School. So kind of had a little bit of both worlds.
Are you married? Have children?
Yes, I'm married to Mr. Larry Latimer.
Glad his name is Latimer. That would have really confused people.
We've been married 29 years, and we have two grown children, a son Derek and a daughter Lauren, and four grandchildren, a fifth one on the way.
Hey, nothing like grandbabies.
No.
Best job I ever had, now I'll tell you that. Holding those grandbabies, and you can go, here you go. Stand those babies right back. No, I'm a papa all the way. I'll tell you all this story. My third daughter graduated from Pahrump, Nevada High School, and she was going to the concert, but her husband was in Michigan running one of those 187-mile things. It's like four of them, and they run over a few days. So he hadn't gotten back, so she didn't go. I mean, I called her up. She says, Dad, do you know what time it is? I said, I don't care what time it is. I want to make sure that you're okay.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was spooky. It was.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk a little. Next of all, Peggy, what do you do with the district?
Well, I work just a few days a week. I'm not full-time as a preschool consultant. My background is... I was director of special education before I retired, and
she retired at 32. Just so you know.
And prior to being director of special education, I was the preschool coordinator.
Oh, were you? Okay.
Yes. So it's just.
So did they have to bring somebody in to save your program, or?
I retired.
Well, they had to bring in another good one then, right?
That's right.
Peggy Carter. I go to church with her, but didn't know her name. But that's not uncommon, because I'll have people speak to me in grocery, and I'll walk by and I'll whisper to my neighbor, who was that? Who was that? And she'll go, I don't know, they knew you. And that's how it works. So now, Miss Caseman, Terry, I got it. Da, da, da. Okay, tell us about your background and what you do, please.
I am one of the preschool teachers at McHale Elementary. We're actually housed at the middle school. I have an associate in applied science, an associate in arts through Maysville Community College, an associate in science through the University of Cincinnati, a bachelor in early childhood through University of Cincinnati, and a master's in interdisciplinary early childhood through Morehead State University.
Terry is a Lewis County graduate.
Yes.
Where did you go to school, Peggy?
Hitchens High School.
That's right, that's right. She's from over there, right past where you turn left, go a long way, over in Hitchens. And we have some friends in common, besides the fact we go to church together. But you know, it was great when you walked to the door, I'm thinking, who is that woman? So now I could ask her and she told me. But I just didn't ring a bell. You're not related to Keith and...
No.
They've had too much fun since they retired. That's all I can tell you.
Do you know Boot Stidham and Grayson?
Well, sure.
Mm-hmm. That's my cousin.
Well, I mean, you got to be related to somebody.
That's right.
You know, she's from Hitchens. We all have to be from somewhere. That's all I can tell you. All right, Miss Latimer, I'm going to play some commercials, and we'll come back and talk about what you do to earn that big check you get down there in Greenup County. Back in a few minutes. This is the OLBH, Greenup Beacon. Meeting.
Everything about Stultz Pharmacy is special because everything they do is aimed at pleasing you, their customer. Low-priced prescription medications, their unsurpassed selection of over-the-counter medications, drop-off and pick-up, drive-through window, free blood pressure screenings, free delivery, large selection of greeting cards, collectibles, Yankee candles, and gift items for all occasions. Just a few of the things that Stultz Pharmacy offers their customers every day. Stultz Pharmacy with locations in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Are you an adult looking for a new career? A high school senior ready for a new and exciting journey? No matter your education goals, we have a path to get you there. We have lots of programs to help you get a high-paying job quickly or work toward a bachelor's degree. Take advantage of the state's lowest tuition, outstanding training programs for jobs in your area, and online classes. Enroll now. Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education.
Welcome to Bellefonte Animal Clinic. Dr. Amy Bess is a licensed veterinarian treating dogs, cats, and other small animals. Your pet's health and well-being are very important, and Dr. Bess and staff will take every step to give your pet the best possible care. Bellefonte Animal Clinic is a full-service animal clinic and will take routine wellness cases as well as medical, surgical, and dental issues. Dr. Amy Bess, Bellefonte Animal Clinic, 1500 Kenwood Drive, Russell. Call 606-
836-9933. Betty Gallion and the Greenup County EMS want you to know the qualified staff is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For transport, call 833-1515. And for medical emergencies, call 911. Greenup County EMS, when seconds count, accepting Medicaid, private insurance, and private pay. Greenup County EMS. Da da da! We made it through the commercials. They're all still conscious. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make it difficult on all three women. First, we're going to talk to Miss Latimer, and she's going to tell us. I'm going to look up what your first name is so I can remember again. I just don't remember what your first name is. Up, oh, I got no, don't tell me. Melissa. Okay, I keep that open over here. Terry, Peggy, Melissa. I'll come up with some, one of those things where you put the letters and you sign words. Yeah, that's the way we do with Sadie Joe. Anyway, tell me about the preschool program, how old it is, the things that you do, and okay. Then you can incorporate... Terry back here, and then we'll ask the old woman over there a few questions.
Okay. All right. Our program has been in operation. This is our fourth year. We are a universal preschool program.
Meaning, okay, define that.
Okay.
That means nothing to me.
Okay. We offer free preschool to all four-year-olds in Greenup County.
Okay. Which is the county district's responsibility.
Yes.
Today.
Yes.
Yes.
You know, in the past, the preschool program would be offered to children if they had a disability or
right.
if they met an income guideline.
So now it's everybody.
It's every four-year-old, yes, that wants to attend. And then we do also provide services for three-year-olds with a disability.
Right.
But our preschool program last year was recently rated a five-star program.
Nice.
Which is the highest rating you can receive. You know, we're really committed to constantly improving our quality of the program and the commitment to our families.
Right.
When we initially started this program, you know, it's all about being a program for children and families. It's not the school's program, it's the community's program. So we really wanted to make it something that would benefit and help our families, help our children, and something that they could be proud of. And we feel like we've really done a great job. All of our teachers are certified teachers in our classrooms. They all have two additional support staff. We provide a full gamut of services from, you know, early intervention if needed for any child, to occupational therapy, speech therapy. We have a special educator that works specifically with preschool children. So we're finding that we're able to identify those needs quicker.
Right.
And 3 years down the road, several children that initially were placed are now testing out of special education, which tells us we're definitely on the right track as far as meeting their educational needs.
Yes, I know. I have a couple of nieces and nephews in Pendleton County that went for speech. Not that they weren't able to absorb and communicate, but they had some speech impediments, and it certainly did help them a great deal. You know, and of course, we're all here, all of us, all kidding aside. I do these shows for the children in the districts, and you guys go to work every day because it's not for the money.
Right.
No teacher teaches for the money, because half of it you put back in what you do. So,
right.
Not half, but some. Yeah. And as we move along here, you inherited this program. You were her immediate predecessor, correct?
No, prior, I was director of the special education, and there was another lady over the preschool for about 4 years.
But you were involved.
Oh, absolutely.
Now, Sadie went out here to the old library. She went 1 year, and then she went to Russell, to first grade. And she must have been pretty good. The building still stands. And but Sadie's a talker. If Peggy knows, everybody that's around Sadie knows Sadie. And we use her in the summer to deliver the papers. And it takes them 2 hours longer because everybody wants to talk to Sadie. So let's turn here and remember you have to speak up. Don't use a Sherry Horsley voice. I have to shove that microphone right at her every time. Tell me what your role as a classroom teacher is. I mean, obviously you follow the programs that are set up, but tell me what your interaction is and the things you face as a teacher.
We are the first experience they have with school, so we want that to be positive when they enter the classroom, because whatever their beginning is and their feelings towards it as a child and as a family continues with them, and that's how they relate to school. So we make that very positive. We incorporate all the areas of development into our classroom. Every activity we do, every material we have has a purpose, a learning purpose. We see each child as an individual. So all of the activities we do, if a child needs modification, if they need extra support, we ensure that we do that by observing, taking notes, doing screenings, to ensure that each child's needs are met in all areas of development. So we want to have them ready for kindergarten. When they're ready to go, we want them as ready as they can possibly be.
Now, Carol taught for 11 or 12 years at Fleming County before she moved here when she was ill. And she believed that every day was a teaching moment for students. And a lot of teachers have fallen victim to this state mandate of, oh no, I have to follow the list. But she tried to apply each day things that happened. She taught AP English and put out the newspaper and yearbook. Hers were national award-winning yearbooks. I even talked to Anna possibly about her coming here and teaching, thinking she would get better and didn't. But at the end of the day, every moment you have is a teaching moment, isn't it?
Yes.
Because it's new exposure. And, you know, Peggy's almost up to grade two now. It took her a while to catch up. I'll be back to pick on them some more in a minute, but we're going to take one more break here on Education in Action. Thanks for being with us, ladies, on the OLPH Greenup Beacon Media Network. Consulting Engineers and Surveyors of Greenup, with offices in Greenup and in Portsmouth. A fine Howerton Engineering and Surveying PLLC, offering many professional services as a professional engineer, surveyor, and much more. Call the Greenup office at 606-473-5000.
5684 or the Portsmouth office at 740-354-3684.
Before I got sick, I enjoyed retirement. This problem with my heart put a monkey wrench in the whole thing.
He was having severe, crushing chest pain. That's what people refer to as a widowmaker.
King's Daughters gave me my life back.
Our program consistently has received the highest rating for cardiac surgical care.
I've never seen nothing any better than King's Daughters. You gave me my life back. You gave me my future and gave me my family.
King's Daughters, online at kdmc.com.
Are not as careful as you are, and Kurt Robinson State Farm Insurance in Flatwoods reminds you to drive carefully at all times. For all your insurance needs, auto, home, life, and health, contact Kurt Robinson Insurance with over 28 years as a State Farm agent. Phone 836-3011. Auto quotes available 24/7 at 836-3011. Kurt Robinson Insurance, 1114 Belfont Road in Flatwoods.
And we're back from the Comedy Hour here at the Flatwoods Public Library, and Education in Action. Three fine guests today: Terry Caseman, Peggy Carter, and Melissa Latimer. I get the Latimer fine. It's that Melissa. I want to call her Teresa and all kinds of names. But we're going to let Peggy, Miss Quiet back there, talk about the grant. So you're up. Talk loud, make a screen thing bounce up and down so they can hear you.
Okay.
Loud's no problem for her.
Last year and this year both, we have written and received a grant from the Department of Early Childhood Education. And this grant allows us to coordinate with a local daycare. And we chose the We Care daycare at McHale at South Shore. And part of my job is to go into the daycare and provide screenings, invite the parents to our parent trainings that we conduct. And by this, we're trying to reach out to others in our community that may not be able to attend our preschool program.
That's great. That really is. So, in summary, what do you see? I know that in education, when I worked for the Nicholas County Board, we were always doing 3 years and 5 years, and here's things we'd like to do. Of course, the commissioner's changing everything now, which is okay by me. I'd like to see him take all that comparative crap away and go back to teaching kids rather than trying to teach tests. But because I grew up in a school teacher's home, and if she decided today that she wanted to teach in English, if she wanted to teach about clouds, she taught about clouds. You know, it was not regimented like it is now, and they're almost afraid. I mean, you teach bell to bell anyway, and you're almost, I know all them phrases.
Yes.
I know them all. And, but you're almost afraid to vary from your case plan or your lesson plan because you might miss something and it might cost somebody something on a test, and that's really not, in my mind, that's not a Renaissance education at all, liberal arts. You're learning facts that someone else decides you should learn. Okay, editorial over. Tell us about what you see as the future, and then we're going to ask Terry what she would like the future to be.
Okay. Well, one thing I would like to say is that in our program, we actually use a project approach to learning. So what's wonderful is that even though we've got to teach kids, Kentucky Early Childhood Standards, our teachers have the freedom to explore what the children are interested in, and mm-hmm. they use that as the beginning to establish what kinds of topics they're going to include in their classroom to teach all of those skills. So it really is very much based on what the child is interested in learning about, which we absolutely love. When we first started this program a few years ago, our readiness, as far as when you do have to look at the numbers, but our readiness for our children in district was around 35% already. Last year, just looking at our preschool children, 76% of our preschool children were ready, and that continues to grow. And so we're just very pleased that our children going in are ready to learn, and our families are ready to support their children for lifelong learning through the parent program that we have along with our
We seem to have program. A big disconnect in education, for particularly at the elementary level, and then at the high school level. The disconnect is that a lot of parents went through a period of, well, I don't care. That's your job. You babysit them, you teach them, and then you send them. Because, again, back to my days in the board office, if you kept them 23 and a half hours a day, they would complain about the half hour you didn't keep them. Right. And that's pretty, I'm overstating it, but I'm not. Because the reality was, no matter what you did, it was never enough. I've seen a turn on that, simply because, and maybe in part because of the testing, maybe. But you guys have obviously gone in the right direction, and that's something you can be proud of. Also, that's great job security, folks, just telling you. Numbers are everything today. It doesn't matter if you're in the private sector or if you're in the education business. Right. And it is a business. Don't think that it's not. Now, is preschool a Title I funding or is it a board funding?
No, it's state funded.
State funded, okay. So your budget's at risk as much as anybody else's then.
Yes, and we are very blessed in that our general fund also supports the preschool program, and that's because of our superintendent. Her understanding and belief in and knowing the importance of a good early childhood foundation.
Right. Well, it's just like I always believe parents should read to children. A lot of people don't believe that. Just give them a phone and let them go.
Yeah. And that's a large part of our program, is also teaching parents their job and their role in supporting their child and how to go about doing that.
I hope Peggy learned. Terry,
yes.
As a classroom teacher, what would you like to see happen over the next 5 years? Obviously not anything in a controversial manner, but you are the front line. You know, you're the general that stands back and tries to work with your staff, and I understand that, and then you have to listen to Peggy. But you tell me about your classroom and what you'd like to see happen. Are there changes you would like to see?
As Ms. Latimer said, we have continued support from Ms. Horsley. We are well supplied with materials, learning activities. The only thing I'd like to see is our program continue to grow, to continue to increase parent involvement, whether it be through our association, our parent group that we're forming, and having officers just like the PTA, but for preschool. Just more involvement and continue to grow and to have more and more children ready for kindergarten and set that stage for a good beginning.
One of the things I didn't ask you, Melissa, when we talk about, when we talk about preschool, how many places do you have it? You have it at McHale and Wortland? And
every elementary school. Has
so
a
you name
program.
Those off.
We have a classroom at Argolite, a classroom at Wortland, a classroom at Gray's Branch, and then we have three classrooms on the McHale at McHale.
Okay.
They're actually on the back part of the middle school.
Okay. So it is a how many student participants in those? Do you have a number?
Yes. Right now, total across the district, we have 147 children.
Right. And I notice. Russell has preschool too, and I know Mr. Horn told me the number, but you know, I still can't remember Melissa, so don't expect me to remember that number. Is there anything you'd like to add, Peggy?
No, I'm just very, very happy to see preschool in this stage that it is in Greenup County.
I am. I really think we're very lucky. I say often, we have three districts that are going gangbang to do the very best they can.
Yes.
And we're very lucky there. We can argue about numbers and positioning all we want, but at the end of the day, it's all for the kids.
Yes.
It's not about anything else. I have one question, Peggy. Is it Peggy Sue?
Well, you know, I was Buddy Holly's inspiration.
So you are Peggy Sue? Oh, no wonder her head's so big. She thinks that song was about her. All right, ladies, anything you'd like to add? Go ahead. Don't you want to say something nice about her? She is your boss.
We're just very thankful to be part of a supportive program.
I know you are.
It is a great program. I hope that parents give us the opportunity to provide services and an educational experience to their children.
Melissa, if people want to talk about this program that have youngsters,
mm-hmm.
may they call you?
Yes, they're more than welcome to call me, 606-473-7936. They can also look us up on, we have a Greenup County Preschool Facebook page,
okay.
Where we post lots of information. And you can also contact each elementary school and talk to the preschool staff.
So if you think your child's going to go to Argolite, then you can mm-hmm. call there. Okay.
Yes.
And each building principal is involved in preschool through.
Yes, very much.
Right, mm-hmm. right. So it's a great thing for our kids. And ladies, I appreciate you being here. Our three guests today have been
Terry
Caseman, Peggy Carter,
Melissa Latimer.
Hot zingers. Next week it's Raceland Independent Schools. I don't know who Larry Coldiron will send, but I hope that he or she is nearly as fun as this trio that showed up that was supposed to be one. But for these ladies, I thank you for joining us. Thanks to Sherry Horsley for supplying our fine guest today, and best of luck to you all in your program.
Thank you.
This is Hank Bond and Education in Action on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.